A very good afternoon, guys. So, welcome to the platform of Fun Academy. I'll be discussing the image-based sessions, all the important images at one place now. I'll be discussing all the images at one place now and so let me give you a brief introduction of the Plus subscription on the Unacademy. So on Unacademy you have Plus subscription where you have daily live classes as well as the live tests and quizzes and structured courses and unlimited access. You also have Iconic subscription where you have Unacademy Plus Prep Ladder. Currently I'm taking an FMG live focus FMG session. I'm doing obstetrics and gynecology, a complete revision of obstetrics and gynecology in that. So you can subscribe to the platform of Unacademy by using a code of Ramya Live. Now in this rapid revision session, I'll show you all the images pertaining to obstetrics which are important for us as a quick review. As a quick review, starting from the first chapters, all the important images. Okay? So you can use the code of Ramya Live for further 10% discount. Okay? And you also have FMG test and analysis batch as well as you also have INE CET 24-day MCQ marathon batch, guys. So these are the other two batches which are running currently, and you have plenty of the batches which run in the Unacademy, whichever suit you best, you can use that. Am I audible and visible to all of you? Yes. So myself, I'm Dr. Ramyasri B. Now we'll start with the session. So the first image based session, first image which I'm going to speak about is this one. So I want you people to answer for this. Okay. So I want you to name what are the structures which you're seeing here. So what is number one here? What is the number one here? What is this layer which you are seeing when which is written as number one? So the number one which you are seeing here is the decidua parietalis. So this is the decidua parietalis. Then next, the number two which you are seeing here, which is covering the uterine gestational sac, is the decidua capsularis, whereas this is decidua basalis. So the part of decidua which is present below the blastocyst is basalis, which is covering the blastocyst is capsularis, which is covering the entire uterine cavity is parietalis, and the fourth one which you're seeing here is the uterine cavity, right? Now this is a picture you see around 16 weeks. So by 16 weeks, the capsularis and parietalis which were there here, they both will fuse together and form decidua vera, right? So this which you are seeing here is the decidua vera. The number 8 is decidua vera. 7 is amniotic cavity. Now we also have a purple color delineated. Purple color is the fetal membranes, right? In the fetal membranes, outer layer is chorion and inner layer is amnion, guys. So this is outer chorion frondosum. The sixth one which you're seeing here is the chorion frondosum. And the rest of the chorion which is towards the uterine cavity is the chorion levae. Chorion levae. So this is chorion frondosum. This number 8, Number 5 is the Korean leeway. Right? And Decidua capsularis and parietalis fuse together to form Decidua vera. So Decidua vera is formed at how many weeks? Decidua vera is formed at 16 weeks. Decidua vera is formed at 16 weeks. Okay. Now one more question. Up to 16 weeks, she can have some amount of bleeding coinciding with her LMP. What do you call that bleeding as? What do you call that bleeding as? So you call it as Hartman sign or placental sign. So it is a physiological bleeding, and you should not confuse this placental sign or Hartman sign with implantation bleeding. Implantation bleeding is seen at the time of implantation or as the implantation ends, that is 10th day after fertilization. So this bleeding, which coincides with her LMP and present till 16 weeks due to unobliterated endometrial cavity, is called as placental sign or placental bleeding or Hartman's sign. It's not APH. APH is bleeding which is present after period of viability. So a placenta, you can observe here, again, types of placentas are very important image-based questions. So this one, which you are seeing a double fold of amnion and chorion. Is the circumvallate. It has a central depression. Next, when the one which is having a peripheral margin is the circummarginate. It has a single fold of amnion and chorion. Circumvallate is associated with antepartum hemorrhage. It's associated with preterm labor and IUGF. So it is associated with antepartum hemorrhage in future. So this is circummarginate. Both circumvallate and circummarginate are called as extrachorial placentation, where you have the chorionic plate smaller than the fetal plate. So this is succinturate lobe. Succinturate lobe is where one cotyledon is separate from the entire placenta. What do the succinturate lobe, what is the problem associated with succinturate lobe? So they can present to you with retained placenta, and they can present to you with secondary PPH, right? This is where you are seeing, this was asked as a previous MCQ, this image. So this is velamentous placenta, guys, where cord is attached to membranes instead of being attached to the placenta, fetal surface of the placenta in middle. If it is attached to membranes, we call it as velamentous placenta. It can get sheared off easily during labor and it will cause fetal hemorrhage. Velamentous placenta is associated with fetal hemorrhage, right? What is this condition? Yes. Excellent, Shipra. So what you're seeing now is called as vasa previa. So vasa previa is where fetal vessels are present below the presenting part. Fetal vessels with membranes are present below the presenting part. You should not get confused between vasa previa and cord presentation, guys. Vasa previa mein only the fetal vessels with membranes will be there. Whereas cord presentation mein full umbilical cord will be present below the presenting part. Okay? So this is vasa previa. So this can be seen with, velamentous placenta. Succinturate placenta, can also be seen with placenta bilobata. Okay. What is the qualitative test to differentiate between fetal and maternal hemorrhage in the vasa previa? And here you have to go for elective LSCS. Never allow them to go into labor, otherwise baby will be dead. So what is a qualitative test to measure the fetal or maternal hemorrhage? So the qualitative test to differentiate between fetal and maternal hemorrhage is excellent. It is the apt test. Apt test. Right? So again, all the pictures together. So this one is the succinurate because it is connected and with membranes. This is succinurate. This is having a central depression like a Golgappa. So it is circumvallate. This is velamentous. When cord is attached to the margin of the placenta, we call it as battledore. I have a picture of cord presentation. I'll show you at the end. Okay. What is the following procedure which you are seeing here in the image? So I've compiled all the images at one place, right? So next image is this. What is this image which you are seeing here? So this is a ultrasound guided transvaginal chorionic villus sampling, guys. So this is chorionic villus sampling. It's a confirmatory test for finding out the fetal aneuploidies. It's a confirmatory test for finding out the fetal aneuploidies, right? And when do you do this chorionic villus sampling? Chorionic villus sampling is done between 10 to 13 weeks. So when you're drawing the amniocytes or drawing the fluid from the amniotic cavity, what is this? It's an ultrasound guided amniocentesis. The second image is ultrasound guided amniocentesis, transabdominal amniocentesis. Amniocentesis is safest and amniocentesis is done between 15 to 20 weeks. It has least chance of abortion. The abortion rate is only 0.5%. Whereas chorionic villus sampling, the abortion rate is around 1 to 2% and it is associated with oromandibular defects or limb reduction defects or limb reduction defects. Okay. Next, here the needle is coming towards the cord. This is called as cordocentesis. Cordocentesis is done between 18 to 20 weeks. This has highest chance of abortions. This has highest chance of abortion. Almost 2 to 3% chance of abortion. Next, very important is this diameters ka. Mainly you are this dot. So I remember this by dot, guys. So this has been asked many times. So what is the blue line? What is the green line? What is the purple line? Lower border of pubic symphysis to sacral promontory, the blue line is called as diagonal conjugate. Lower border of pubic symphysis to the sacral promontory is called as diagonal conjugate, DC. It is a measurable conjugate. It is the measurable conjugate, right? Green one, posterior surface of pubic symphysis to sacral promontory is called as obstetric conjugate. So how do I remember this? From below upwards, dot. D-O-T, dot. From below upwards, dot. That is how I remember, guys. And the upper one, the upper surface of pubic symphysis to sacral promontory is called as true conjugate. It's called as true conjugate. Okay. So this has been asked as an image based question many times. So you have to remember from below upwards it is dot. Dot. Diagonal obstetric true. Diagonal obstetric true. Okay. Right. Next is the engaging diameters. So actually, I've done a mnemonic video on the engaging diameters, but I think it is under the free classes, so it has been removed. So I thought anyway, I'll tell you the mnemonic by a YouTube video. So I'll speak about that mnemonic now in this session. Okay? Now this is regarding the engaging diameters. The degree of the flexion of the fetal head is changing, right? So during the process of engagement, whatever might be the degree of flexion, the transverse engaging diameter is always biparietal diameter, guys, which is 9.5 centimeters. But the anteroposterior engaging diameter keeps changing. So some of you already know the mnemonic, some of you, if you don't know, you can learn it now, right? So anteroposterior engaging diameter changes for each one depending on the degree of the flexion of fetal head. If you observe here, the first one, it is complete flexion. This is complete flexion. Second one, it is a deflection. Chin is not touching the chest. So it's a deflection, or you can also call it as military position. The third one is partial extension. And the fourth one is the complete extension. Fourth one is the complete extension. Right? Now, a very easy way of remembering. Imagine there are two friends. Okay? So, two friends. One friend is crying. One ladka is crying. One boy is crying. Okay? So, what is the posture taken in the crying? So, normally we take this posture, no, to cry. So, full as a mudke, we will be crying, no? Same way the baby is crying here also. So, this boy is going on crying. Crying in English is also called as sob. Crying in English is also called sob, right? So, complete flexion, you can remember it as sob. Suboccipitobrachmatic. Thank you, Jishan. Thanks a lot. So, sob is suboccipitobrachmatic. It is 9.5. This boy is crying and he has decided to join military office. The second mnemonic is military office opens at 12. So military, this, who is the person who sees straight? Military people. So this is the military position. This is the military position. It's also called military position. Office, OF, occipitofrontal. And how many centimeters is it? 12 centimeters. So the boy is sobbing and boy is telling, I'm joining military office at 12 o'clock. Okay? But the next one, his friend comes and tells. So when in the partial extension, Shreyansh, please don't shout. Please don't shout, Shreyansh. Next, partial extension may, if you do PV, what are you going to see? What is the presenting part which you are going to have if you are having partial extension? It is the bro. It is bro. Right? So the presenting part is bro. So the mnemonic here is bro move, it's 14th Feb. So his friend is coming and telling bro move. Why are you as a mool at kake kyu baite? Oh, it was audible. I thought I have muted. I did muting and I shouted, but I think it was audible. I'm very sorry. So bro move, it's 14th Feb. So bro move, 14th Feb, it is the bro move, MV, mento vertical, and it is 14 centimeters. So partial extension may, it is bro, it is mento vertical and it is 14 centimeters. Right? Okay? So last one, complete extension may, face. So the story up till now here is baby is crying, the boy is crying. He decided to go military office at 12 o'clock. But his friend is coming and telling, bro, move. It's 14 Feb, Valentine's Day. Go meet your girlfriend. Don't do all such stupid things. Okay? But why did he take all this decision of crying, military offices? Because his girlfriend told him sambar face. So the last mnemonic is sambar face. This is the highlight of the mnemonic. Sambar, SMB, sub-mento brigmatic. And complete extension, mein, what is the presenting part? What is the presenting part in complete extension? Face. So face presentation, it is the sub-mento brigmatic, which is again 9.5 centimeters. So I hope it was, it is easy for you to remember. Now before exam, sambar is a, if you are not aware what is sambar, I think all of you are aware of what is sambar. Sambar is a dish of South India, which we make it with dal. Right? So this is an easy way you can remember. Okay? Now I have some more points to put forward. Bro mein mento vertical is 14 centimeters. Bro mein mento vertical is 14 centimeters. What will be the mode of delivery for mento, bro mento vertical? It will be cesarean section. It is the cesarean section, right? Because we can never do vaginal delivery for a 14 centimeters. We can never do a vaginal delivery for 14 centimeters. So I hope you all enjoyed this mnemonic and it will be helpful for all of you before your exam. So simple. First, complete flexion, sob, he's crying. Second, military office opens at 12. So military position, office, OF, occipitofrontal, 12 centimeters. Third one, bro move, 14th Feb, bro, mento vertical, 14 centimeters. Mode of delivery, cesarean section. Last one, sambar face, SMB, submento brigmatic face presentation. Right? Next, very important, even in your dreams also you should answer, is Leopold Manners, guys. Last exam you had in INECET, one of the picture of Leopold Manners, as well FMG December also, they have given Leopold Manners as an image based question. So all of you should be perfect with Leopold Manners. So in the Leopold Manners, the first Leopold Manners is the fundal grip. First is fundal grip, right? Fundal grip, here you try to feel what is present or what is present in the fundus. If it is a soft, broad, irregular, it is the buttocks. First is the fundal grip. Second is the lateral grip or the umbilical grip. Second is the umbilical grip or the lateral grip. Just a minute, I don't know why it's not functioning. Right. So I'll just speak about the Leopold Manners without writing. So first Leopold Manners is the fundal grip, where you're seeing what is present in the fundus, right? So if you have a hard, curved and globular structure, which is ballottable, it is the fetal head. It is the head. If you see, there is a soft, irregular, broad, then it is the buttocks. Second grip is also called as lateral grip or umbilical grip. This will tell you which side is the spine and which side are the limbs. If you feel smooth, curvilinear, that is the spine. If you feel there is multiple knob-like structures, then it is the limbs. then it is the limbs, right? Next, third, first three manures are by seeing the patient's face. Third Leopold is also by seeing the patient's face. Fourth Leopold manure is by seeing the patient's feet. Third is also called as Pollux grip. It will tell you whether the presenting part is engaged or not engaged. Thumb on one side, four fingers on other side. Fourth Leopold manure is by seeing the patient's feet. If your hands are converging, then it is presenting part is engaged. Sorry, if hands are converging, presenting parts is unengaged. If hands are diverging, then presenting part is engaged. Right? So this is regarding the Leopold manures. You have to see the Leopold manures and name them accordingly as an image-based question. Next, what is this manure which you are seeing in the second stage? So this manure where you are seeing, where you are observing the hand, one hand to support the perineum and one hand to maintain the flexion of the fetal head, this is called as Ridgen's manure. Ridgen's manure. So second stage you use Ridgen's manure where you are doing the controlled delivery of the fetal head, right? What is this manure? One hand on the abdomen, with another hand you hold the cord and you are pulling the cord in a to and fro motion. So what is this manure? So this is called as Brandt's Andrew method, or we also call it as control cord traction. Brandt's Andrew method or control cord traction. So it is done for active management of third stage of labor. Active management of third stage of labor. So next we have the external cephalic version, which is used I didn't understand your query, Jishan, if you can put forward, frame it again. So external cephalic version is where you're turning the buttocks up and trying to pull the fetal head down. So this is the backward flip. You should know everything about ECV, guys. So as of now, I'm just showing you the image, but you should know each and every point about ECV. Very important. This is the forward roll of ECV. This is the forward roll of ECV. Okay. So what is this manure which you're seeing in this image? So it is something related to the breech where occiput is facing the sacral promontory. Occiput facing the sacral promontory and you are pulling the baby as an arc up. What is this called as? So it is not Bern Marshall. It is not Bern Marshall. This is called modified Prague method. Whenever the aftercoming head of breech is in OP position. Whenever aftercoming head of breech is in OP position. Yes, Leopold manures you can use for transverse fetal position also, and in transverse fetal position you will have lower pole empty. Okay, not much helpful. Everywhere you will get the findings where lower pole is empty, and once the lower pole is empty you don't do the third and fourth manures at all, right? So after coming head in breech, if it is in OP position, you use this manure called as modified Prague method, where you're flexing the entire body as an arc. When is Bern Marshall? Bern Marshall is ulta of this. I'll show you Bern Marshall also. This is Bern Marshall, where you hold the feet at ankle. Pull up vertically as an arc. This is Bern Marshall. So Bern Marshall mein after coming head is OA position. Bern Marshall mein after coming head of breech is OA position. So this is Bern Marshall, and ulta of Bern Marshall is modified Prague method, guys. Ulta of Bern Marshall is modified Prague method. Okay? What is this manure which you are seeing next? What is this manure which you are seeing next? where you are giving suprapubic pressure and malaflexion. This is called as Vigor-Martin method, guys. This is called Vigor-Martin technique for after coming head of breech. It is not MSV, it is called Vigor-Martin. So I hope you are able to utilize this for correcting your mistakes, right? So this is not MSV. Here only suprapubic pressure and malar flexion we are giving. This is called Vigor-Martin technique. If you are having suprapubic pressure with shoulder traction with malar flexion, three hands, three names, Mauritius Smelly Wheat Manure. Two hands, two names. Two hands may two names, that is Vigor-Martin, suprapubic pressure and malar flexion. If you are having three hands, that is malar, suprapubic pressure, malar flexion and shoulder traction, all the three names together, then it is Mauritius Smelly Wheat technique. Okay. I hope you all understood the difference between Vigor-Martin and MSV. MSV may you have shoulder traction also, whereas Vigor-Martin may there is no shoulder traction. Vigor-Martin may there is no shoulder traction. Okay. Next, what is this manure where you are rotating the fetus by femoropelvic grip 180 degrees on either side, like a steering of the car? This is called as Lovesett's manure. This is called Lovesett's manure. Okay. So Lovesett's manure is for extended arm or nuchal displacement of arm. Lovesett manure is for extended arm or nuchal displacement of arm. How can you? I have seen many students getting confused between Lovesett's and Wood corkscrew. Wood corkscrew may fetal head will be outside. When buttocks are outside and you are rotating 180 degrees, it is Lovesett's. So how can you remember is Lovesett's with extended arm. Kule haath pyaar badhta hai. Open hands, love magnifies or whatever. So Lovesett's with extended arm. That's how you can remember Lovesett's extended or nuchal displacement of arm. Right? Next. So when you are putting a finger in the popliteal fossa and pulling the leg out, we call this as Pinard's manure. Pinard's manure is for arrested lower limb. Pinard's manure is for arrested lower limb. Okay. What is this manure where you are holding the baby's leg and pulling it out? Pinard's was popliteal fossa, but here you are holding the leg and pulling it out. So this is called internal podalic version. This is internal podalic version. So if you observe, I have kept all your manures at one place and try to do it as an image based, right? So this is the internal podalic version, which is done for transverse lie of second twin. Transverse lie of second twin. Okay. So by this I conclude all the manoeuvres at one place and one mnemonic for engaging diameter. So this will be very useful for you to revise at once also later. All the images and manoeuvres at one place. Okay. And I'll try to plan one more session before your exam where I'll discuss other images, whatever. I have some more images compiled with me. Which are important for you in the obstetrics and gynecology. Those images I'll show in the second session. Okay? Thank you guys. Yes, here we didn't do the shoulder dystocia manoeuvres. So I'll also put images for shoulder dystocia. Okay? So thank you guys. Keep studying. All the best. And work hard for the next 10 days. And don't think anything apart from your studies. This is the most crucial period. Don't think how is the situation, exam won't postpone, you have to go and give the exam, but just be positive that all of you will do great, right? Thank you guys.